passing away earlier this week at the age of 79, Junior Coffey left a positive mark in Washington thoroughbred racing. Memories of Coffey lean toward his friendly approach and infectious smile, and the hundreds of interesting stories that made up his life. From breaking racial ground in Texas, starring in football in college and the NFL, and 50 years with horses. He was a true horse whisperer, getting his runners to peak performance level mentally and physically. He's just one of six Emerald Downs trainers to win at over 20% lifetime. He opened eyes in the 1970s by greatly improving Fancy Native to stakes winner. He claimed young filly Cruisin' Too Sue at Portland Meadows for Jeff Wilson, and she won her first five under Coffey, beating a top field in the Betsy Ross handicap.
It is Cruisin' Too Sue, higher sweeper Debonair. There she, under Vicky Evergun, is Cruisin' Too Sue.
He trained one of the most impressive juvenile fillies in Washington bred history.
It is Runaway Stevie. Oh, she is gone. It's Runaway Stevie.
Jack and Ivor Jones' Runaway Stevie was still going great 5 years later during Emerald Downs' inaugural season. Longtime clients also included Perry and Beatrice Levinson, Jeff Sissel, Rick Pasco, and Ron Crockett. Raised the Bluff finished second in the Gottstein, won the Emerald Downs Derby, and was favored in the 2007 Long Acres Mile.
Raise the Bluff takes the lead in the Long Acres Mile with a great face fighting back. Stride to stride, the great face. The great face has won it.
That was a near miss in the mile for Coffey, but his outstanding career continued. He won with his final starter, Levitation, in September of 2018. Smiles and stories forever when it comes to remembering Junior Coffey.